You might be asking, why am I doing a talk video on the Mr. Endboss channel? Do I not do those talk videos on my other channel, which is now called Mr. Enderboss? Well, yes, I did, and the reason why I'm gonna be doing talk videos now on this channel is because, well, not many of you guys want to watch my talk videos from another channel. So what I'm gonna do is this channel is still gonna be dedicated to gaming. But except I'm gonna be doing some talk videos sometimes. And yeah. So for this video, I'm gonna talk a little bit about YouTube Kids. And you probably read the title and you're like, why is YouTube Kids not for kids? Well, this is where I'm going to explain to you guys. Let's get straight into this. So you might remember about 2, 3 years ago, there was this thing called Elsa Gates, and pretty much what that was, it was pretty much where people would make videos, like inappropriate videos for children, but it's like it's promoted to children, meaning that they would make a real life video of like Spider-Man and Elsa and things like that, and kids would see it, and you know. I mean, it was just bad, you know? It was just really bad. And, well, we're not gonna talk about Elsa Gates. That's not what this video is really about, but I just wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about it. But at first, these Elsa Spider-Man videos, they weren't that bad. They were actually, like, there was nothing inappropriate in them. Until, like, mid-2017, 2018, these videos started to become a bit more inappropriate and too disturbing for kids. And YouTube have chosen to do nothing about these channels until they decided to terminate some of these channels, but the worst, it was still pretty bad. Now, Elsa Gates isn't only the Spider-Man Elsa videos that were inappropriate. There were also like animation videos that were also inappropriate. Like, there were animations of them murdering each other's, and you know, that's not something that you should show to kids. And I must point out, I myself, as a kid, I saw some of those videos, and I was traumatized for life. So, to the creators of these videos, thank you so much. Anyways, now we're gonna move on to the Coppola. Okay, so you might be asking, why am I gonna talk again about the Coppola when I made two videos talking about the Coppola? One about like 5, 6 months ago, and another one that was about a month ago. Well, pretty much the difference is that in those Coppola videos, pretty much what I did is, in the first one I did was talking about my personal experience with the law, and I wasn't like affected that bad. I chose willingly to put all my Minecraft videos for kids, but then I saw that there were no comment section, you know, I just decided to not put them for kids, I guess. And in the second video, I talked about how COPPO was even a thing and why it was a thing. And now, in this video, I'm gonna talk about why the COPPOLA is just dumb. Like, it's pointless, it's stupid, and like the videos, and most of the videos shown on with COPPA, they're not even made for kids. Like, they're actually not made for kids. Like, how the COPPA law works is that if they see a Minecraft video, they'll put it for kids because Minecraft is a kids game apparently. Although apparently adults are not allowed to enjoy Minecraft. And this is just what I hate about the Coppola. Like, it's just, it could have been handled so much better, you know? Like, I thought at first that it wasn't gonna be like that. I didn't think the Coppola was gonna be like that. How I thought it was gonna be is I thought that like if someone wants to sign into YouTube, they would have to put like their birthday, like the day that they were like given birth, and like they would need to put the parents' email if the kid is under 13, because according to YouTube's policy, to have a channel, you must be 13 and older. And for the kids that are less than 13, they could put their parents' email while signing in, and if they want to sign in, the parents gets an email from YouTube saying, "Hey, do you want your kids to be on YouTube right now or not?" And they can say yes or no. But no, instead they blame the content creators. Like, the people who made the law and YouTube are blaming the creators for not making content for kids. Well, I'm not sure if it is actually like that, but it just feels like that they're blaming their own creators. Like, YouTube is blaming their own creators for not making videos for kids. Like I said at the beginning, there was Elsa Gates, and that's not for kids, but it was promoted for kids. And there's plenty of YouTubers out there that make family-friendly videos, like, for YouTube, for kids. And, like, I am kind of one, but it's just I play, like, other types of games, like Watch Dogs 2 and Far Cry 5, but these games are not really for kids, right? And, like, the way that YouTube handled the COPPA law, it's just stupid. And literally, like, I saw a couple videos on Minecraft, and these videos had curse words in them. Like, they had a bit of a couple F-bombs here and there, a couple S-words, I think like one or two B-words. But yet, I would think that that wouldn't be made for kids because, you can't promote cursing to kids. No, it's for kids. Like, this is just so stupid. Like, I mean, sure, maybe the parents should monitor what their kids are watching, but YouTube for Kids is supposed to be like a secure app for the kids to watch. And with the COPPA policy, it's not working. And it's useless, it's pointless, and it's just dumb. And it really feels like YouTube and the people who make the law, which I'm guessing is the US government, are blaming the content creators, and that is not good. That is not good at all, and that's what I hate about COPPA. This is just what I hate. And the effects of COPPA is also that if your video is made for kids, 70 to 90% of your ad revenue is just gone, meaning that you can't have ads on the video. Now, I don't get any ads because I don't have enough subscribers, but how are you supposed to make money when your video's for kids? Like, I just don't get it. Do you get money from the views, maybe? Maybe you get money from the views, but I mean, most YouTubers, how they make their money is from ads and brand deals, and I never gotten any sort of that stuff, so that doesn't really concern me. But still, it's not good for other YouTubers. Now, the channels that were hit really, really hard for the COPPA law, pretty much every single channel on the platform, like, whether it's gaming or, like, I don't know, makeup tutorials, they were all hit with the COPPA policy. And the channels that were hit very hard with this and the were toy review channels and even gaming channels. Like, there were some gaming channels that, like, their Minecraft videos or their videos just on kids game. Like, I think maybe the game Fall Guys maybe falls into that category. They're made for kids, although there's cursing in them, and it's just stupid. And I came across a couple days ago a YouTube channel where it's a rapper, and I mean, the music isn't that bad, but it's not the music the problem. It's the COPPA policy, how it hit him. Pretty much, he makes music videos about, like, murder and drugs, which is bad for kids, but yet, it's for kids. Like, what is YouTube doing? Oh yeah, kids like to murder and do drugs. That's what kids like to do, don't they? Yeah, it's not. Kids do not do that. Like, I mean, when I was growing up as a young kid, like in the mid 2010s, like things were much better. Like I didn't even know what YouTube was at that time. I only started watching YouTube back in 2016 when I was about like 10, I think. But apart from that, like when I grew up, it's just like it was just so much simpler because, well, I didn't have anything to traumatize me, aka the Elsa Gaze videos, although I watched them when I was like 9 and 10. It still kind of traumatized me because there was a char another character in the Elsa Gaze videos that was the Hulk, and I remembered when I was younger, I was like, I really liked Hulk, and seeing Hulk do these things just traumatized me. Although I wasn't interested in Hulk anymore at that time, it still kind of traumatized me because, you know, he used to be my favorite character in the Marvel franchise, and seeing Hulk do these things, it's just messed up, man. Like, I mean, these Elsa Gaze videos, I mean, they're pretty much gone now, but it was pretty bad when they were still uploading these videos, and YouTube, and it was even promoted on the YouTube Kids app. That's how bad it was. And well, YouTube for Kids, COPPA, it's not for kids. It's actually not. And for the parents listening out there, don't even let your kids watch YouTube in general. YouTube do not make any sort of content for kids. They don't even try to make it for kids. They don't even try at all. Like, they just say like, oh, videos for kids, a video on Minecraft, that's for kids, bam. Although there's curse words in them, we still include them as for kids. And like, YouTube is just getting a it's just being a worse platform in general, you know, like it's just bad. And I don't know if it's me, but YouTube is becoming a worse platform. I mean, maybe some of you guys can agree. I mean, as a viewer, like as someone who watches videos on YouTube, it's still an awesome platform, like still a great platform to watch videos. But for the content creators, the people who make these videos on YouTube, it's bad. It's just horrible. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to leave a like and also subscribe to my channel. If you haven't, it would be greatly appreciated. Now, although I said I wasn't gonna do talk videos on this channel, I will do more talk videos. This is gonna be something I do sometimes, but this channel will still be dedicated to gaming. And if you want, you can watch the videos on my Mr. Enderboss channel that I uploaded. I'll put the channel at the end screen. But anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will talk to you on the next one. And as always, stay under, everyone.